first, let me show you our results, and next, I'll give you some background on the design. In particular, I clarify the relationships among the five divisions of the language. And I will explain motivation, our motivation. And our motivation is to investigate around complexity. And I propose a three-round knowledge protocol and demonstrate its knowledge property. And finally, I conclude. Okay, let me show you our results. I'm going to present the first construction of three-round knowledge protocol for any NLP language. And this is not block-box simulation of knowledge, but it's achieved auxiliary non-informed knowledge. This is a bigger notion of knowledge. And in order to demonstrate our knowledge property, I introduce a new simulation technique. This is a non-black box simulation, and it's based on the computational assumption called strong difficult assumption. Yeah, I start by reviewing the notion of interactive protocol for language memory problems. We consider two-party protocols, the approver and the verifier. They take a common input X, and the approver tries to convince the verifier that X belongs to language there through the interaction. And the interactive protocol requires two conditions. One is the completeness, and the other is the soundness. The completeness means if X belongs to language L, then the verifier always accepts X. And the soundness requires if X does not belong to language L, then any cheating prover cannot make the verifier accept X. So the probability that the verifier accepts is very small, and it's negligible. And the knowledge is a special property of interactive protocols. It requires means that any cheating verifier gains no information by interacting with the prover. And this notion is formalized based on the simulation paradigm. So for any cheating verifier, we have to test the simulator S, and such that these two distributions are computationally distinguished. One distribution is the verifier's whole conversation. It means the whole conversation verifies gets by interacting with the prover. And second distribution is the output distribution of simulator test. So this means the simulator can output the whole conversation of the verifier. Without interacting with the prover. And we consider two dimensions in this definition, in this formalization. One dimension is about auxiliary input Y. In some definitions, the verifiers are allowed to take any auxiliary input. And in other definitions, the verifiers are not allowed. And the another dimension is about the computational model of the verifier and the simulator. In the uniform model, they are modeled by probabilistic polynomial time machines. And in the non-uniform model, they are modeled by polynomial size circuit farming. So here we have four kinds of definitions of the knowledge. The GMR knowledge is the original definition, and the interior input knowledge, KIGK, and the non-uniform knowledge, NGK, and finally, interior input non-uniform knowledge. And our proposed protocol satisfies this notion, these definitions. There is another Brock Loop. There is another definition of real knowledge. It's a Brock Loop simulation of real knowledge. It is the most famous because all non-zero knowledge properties have been demonstrated using this notion, using the black box simulation. So all non-zero knowledge possible the DFTK. And this description requires the existence of a single universal simulator. It uses any cheating verifier as the black box. So this notion formalized as follows. Now we have five kind of definitions. So let me show the relationships among them. DSTK is the strongest definition. So DSTK implies all other definitions. And AIGK is also, DSTK is the most suitable for practical application, crypto application. And the AIGK is also considered to be suitable for cryptographic application. This is because AIGK is closed under the sequential compression. But not GNRGK is not considered to be suitable for cryptographic application because GNRGK is not closed under the sequential compression. And our achieved definition, AIMGK, is also closed under the sequential compression. But unfortunately, AIMGK does not imply AIGK. This is because there is a protocol which satisfies AIMGK, but not AIGK. So I don't know whether AIMGK is suitable for cryptographic application. Let me explain our motivation. Our motivation is to investigate the royal bounds and the ground complexity. And this table shows the royal bounds regarding three definitions. For example, the royal bound regarding DFTK is 3. And this is because the 3-rand DFTK protocol is only for BBP language. And the BBP language has a trivial knowledge. So we can consider 3 as the royal bound. And in addition to that, this royal bound is actually tight because it is well known to exist a 4-rand DSTK protocol for any empty language. And the royal bounds regarding AIMGK or AIGK are also known. They are 2. But it is unknown whether these royal bounds are actually tight. So, in other words, it is an open problem whether there exists a 3-rand AIGK or AIMGK protocol for non-trivial language, like such as empty language. And in this talk, we solved this problem affirmatively with respect to the AIMGK. But our result does not apply to AIGK, so this problem is still open with respect to the AIGK. Let me explain how to construct our 3-rand real knowledge protocol. Our starting point is a 3-rand public point honest verifier real knowledge proof for an empty complete language. M1 and M2 are Kruger's message, and Y is a verifier's public point. When the verifier receives an M2, he checks if M2 is valid, and if it is true, the verifier accepts common index. And the typical example of starting protocol is a parallel composition of ground state knowledge group for Hamiltonian circuit problem. And this is an NP concrete language. And I want to transform this protocol into another three-round protocol which satisfies the zero knowledge property against any cheating verifier. So our approach is simple. We replace the verifier's public point Y by an interaction between the prover and the verifier. And we use some standard notation related to the discrete logarithm program. Q is the prime, such that t equals 2 times q plus 1, and g is an element of order q. And for simplicity, we omit the expression of order p. Okay. I'd like to present the three-round zero knowledge protocol. As you see, the red messages are added to the starting protocol. And Y is generated by an interaction, the prover and the verifier. And in the first step, in the first round, prover generates M1, EQG, and picks a random number, A, and computes capital A, and send them to the verifier. And the verifier picks a random number, B, and computes capital B and capital X, and send to the prover. And the prover checks if x equals b to a. And if it is true, prover picks a random number c and computes capital C and capital Y, and also computes m2 according to the starting protocol and sends to the verifier. And verifier similarly checks if y equals c to b and m2 is valid. If both conditions are satisfied, verifier accepts common interface. This check is important for the knowledge property, and this check is important for soundness condition. I'd like to show this protocol satisfies the zero knowledge property. And to do so, we have to construct a simulator. But before constructing the simulator, let me observe the property of this protocol. This protocol is no longer a public point protocol because more B is a secret point of the verifier. And because it is hard to compute more B from the capital B and capital S. So, and I designed this protocol so that as long as B is kept secret, the soundness condition is satisfied. In other words, once B is revealed, the soundness condition is no longer satisfied. So our observation is that as follows. Once the simulator gets secret point B, the simulation is easy to do. And that a question arises here. And the question is how the simulator can get secret point B. In order to answer this question, I introduced a computational assumption called Sturm-Diffie-Hellman assumption. And this slide focuses on the first round and the second round. It is easy to see that if verifier called specialized protocol. The verifier always passes the progress check. But it seems that verifiers must know the secret point B in order to pass the progress check. So we assume that any cheating verifier cannot pass the progress check without knowing the secret point B. I define the strong uniform assumption run in the non-uniform model. We consider two circuit family. Circuit C is similar to the verifier's computation. Circuit C takes as input PQG and A, and try to output capital B and X, and satisfy the X equal B to A. And this corresponds to a Krugers check. And we consider another circuit, C prime. C prime takes same input and output, but not only capital B, capital S, but also secret point B. And SDHA1 says for any circuit C, take this another circuit C prime, and if X equal B to A, then it holds that B equal G to B. So this means whenever circuit C outputs BX satisfying X equal B to A, the circuit C knows the secret point B. And this assumption is fundamentally different from the standard complexity assumption, such as a one-way function, because there are two quantifiers. In the standard complexity assumption, there is only one quantifier. So this assumption seems very strong, but I believe this assumption is reasonable. And I can prove that a strong Diffie-Hellman assumption 1 implies a Diffie-Hellman assumption. And this is why that's why we call this assumption strong Diffie-Hellman assumption. Okay, let me sketch the proof of the analysis. Let me stress, you can no longer use this black box simulation technique. So we need non-black box simulation technique. And now I know that under SDHA1, for any cheating verifier that we have, there exists another cheating verifier, we have prime. And we have prime output the secret point B. Our idea is very simple. Our idea is to use we have prime as a black box. We don't use we have as a black box. And so that the simulator can get secret point B. So we have prime can be considered as a secret point extractor. Okay, this is the outline of the simulation process. In the first step, the simulator runs the honest verifier simulator of the starting protocol. So that the simulator gets a conversation of starting protocol, M1, Y, and M2. And step two is important step. Simulator uses we have prime as a black box. And as a result, simulator can get secret point B. And once B is known, it is easy to compute capital C satisfying the white box C to B. And this corresponds to verifier check. And finally, the simulator can output whole conversation. And so this is not a black box simulation, because the simulator never used Free Hat as a black box. It uses Free Hat Prime as a black box. Okay, let me explain, let me discuss why our proposed protocol must be AINGK, not AIGK. So, common effects and auxiliary line are given non-uniformly to the verified. So therefore, SDHA1 must be formalized in the non-uniform model. And as a result, our simulator is non-uniform polynomial size circuit function. And so our protocol only achieves AINGK, but not AIGK. Before I conclude, let me introduce a related bug. I was not aware of the Dangard bug when I was writing our paper. He introduced the SDHA at the Crypt Conference 91. This is the title of his paper. His purpose is to construct a public liquid system secure against cross-site-based attack. So his purpose is different from ours. But interestingly, he also pointed out that SDHA implies non-black box simulation technique. However, he didn't present a three-random knowledge or a non-trivial language, as I did here. In conclusion, I have proposed the three-round zero knowledge protocol, and I have shown under SDHA1 our protocol satisfies AINGK. And I did not mention about the soundness, but the soundness function is satisfied under SDHA2. And this is a similar assumption to SDHA1. And so I conclude with our theorem, which says there exists a three-round AINGK argument for any NLP language under SDHA. That's all.
Thank you. We have time for